plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Hold tight and welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. Today we are going to look at non-return valves. This is a non-return valve right here. Now firstly, you will see there's an arrow. That tells you which way this valve should go. So inside, it moves one way or t'other. See that? If I blow with the arrow, it comes out. If I blow against it, nothing comes out. Before we carry on with this video, I just wanted to apologise for my voice. I've been on a cricket tour and I've come back and I don't have much of a throat at the moment. I have no idea why. So we are going to go and have a look at where you can install one of these. I'm going to show you how to install one on a basin, and hopefully you'll learn a little bit about where you can put them, why you install them, and how they work. Hold tight throughout the night. Right, first up, we've got this sink here. Now, on one side of this sink, we've got mains cold water, and on the other side of this sink, we've got a pretty poor flow on the hot water side. Now, there's no non-return valve on the hot water side yet. So, what happens is, say you've got the hot water open, so you open it up, there's not much coming out. You open up the cold, and it flies out at a much higher pressure and pushes cold water back down that hot pipe. So then we open this up, the hot is now running cold, because all that cold water can push down that pipe, and wait a few minutes and then it'll come back hot again. To prevent this happening, we put a non-return valve in that will go in this way around on the hot side and stop the cold water pushing back down that pipe and back down the system. Now I'm going to show you how to install one of these. It's as easy as 1, 2, 3 or ABC. It's just two compression fittings. And then I'll go to the drawing board and show you schematically where you'll find one of these. So, firstly, let's go under this sink and find out our hot and cold. Now, I've been running the hot for a while, so that one there is nice and warm. So that's the hot now. Just get your screwdriver or whatever and turn that off. And it's not a bad thing just to turn the cold off as well, just in case. Put that here. Turn that off too. And just make sure they're both off. So, going back under here, we've got a small little bit of copper pipe just here. We've also got our flexi. Now, my plan is to pop our non-return valve here and then add it at the flexi at the top. Just loosen that off and take that away. Probably going to get a little bit of water out that's been sitting in that hose. There we go. What I'll do now, because we've got light new olives on here, is take this piece of pipe out. Now we can build our new section of pipe. So firstly, I'm just going to cut a small length of 15mm. Pop our olive and our nut on. Alright, next, cut another small piece of pipe and pop that right down as far as it will go and tighten that up. Right, because we've got that, I'm just going to cut this piece down, and also it's the end of the length of copper pipe. Now this bit's slightly wider, and often find a pipe slice makes a beautiful taper for it to push into a compression fitting. You see the difference in end there? Nice little taper that end. Hard, horrible, pooey end there. Ugh. Right, so now we pop a nut and olive on this end, and a nut and olive on this end. Now is the time to make sure you've got the arrow pointing in the right direction. Now we want the hot water to be coming up through in line with this arrow. So our valve is going to be on the bottom here and our flexible hose is going to be on the top here. So let's install that now.
So let's pop our... tighten this up. Got that on there like that. Fortunately, I think this pipe's got a bit of give in it. So we can just push that down. Get our new nut and olive on and get our flexible on without it kinking. Now we will tighten up the nut and olive for our flexible. So our arrow is in the right direction, as you can see. Now we should be able to turn the water on, test for leaks, make sure everything's all right.
Right, so we've turned everything back on and tested for leaks, and there are none. I mean, I'd expect nothing less from myself. I back myself not to get leaks on 15mm copper pipe. So let's firstly see whether the hot water has got enough pressure to actually push the non-return valve open. Bear in mind that the pressure here wasn't very good in the first place, so I'm not expecting a great deal here. And that's pretty much where it was earlier on. Now, let's let it run through really, really hot. Let's get in there now. Now let's open up the cold. Shut the cold. Straight away it's hot again. So there we go. We now know that the cold water cannot push down that non-return valve and into the hot water system.
So this is a certain type of system we can have. We've got the taps, hot and cold tap here. This is what we've just done. We've got our two valves there, and we've basically just put a non-return valve in just here so the cold water cannot go back down that tap and off to the system. So that's one way of using a non-return valve there that we've just shown you how to do. But there are others. For example, you can have an industrial pump set with two pumps on it like that. The idea is you only have one pump on at one time. Now, you don't want this pump to go on and then it pump its water round here and then back through that pump and then round in a circle. So what you do, you get a check valve and put that there. So it cannot pump round. It has to go off to the system. That's one way of using one there. Combi boilers, they will have a cold water main coming in where it gets heated through a heat exchanger and then goes off to your hot water. Now, to prevent any water going back down the cold water main, you'll have a check valve on there. That's another one. So, like any plumber will tell you, non-return valves can go in loads of different places. They're so versatile and they get used for so many different things. You guys who are watching these videos, I know you all pretty well by now. There's a lot of you out there. You know what you're on about, a lot of you. So, if you think there's any way that we've missed anything or anything like that, just put on the comments below. Help some of the other viewers who aren't so clued up with what we're doing. George here, my cat, is... he doesn't really like plumbing. He's pretty temperamental. He's not as good as Jack. Jack's like so much better. The dog, he's a legend. Follow us on Twitter, follow us on Facebook, subscribe to our videos. Give us any love. If you've got any questions, as usual, come to us. George will tell you there's a lot of lap time. He's quite moody, isn't he? Cats are grumpy. All right, thanks ever so much for watching, guys. I will see you next week. Remember, hold tight throughout the night and the cat's going to bail. See ya! Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
He's just been outside. He smells all fresh and that. George, cats. They're just so annoying, aren't they?